Alright, everyone. Welcome again. This is my second video, playing video games that you choose. And this one you guys have chosen is Aaahh, Real Monsters for the Super Nintendo by Nickelodeon, obviously. Now let's take a look. Alright, let's go to our opciones here and take a look and see what we can do. Difficulty, there's scary, nightmare, and scary. It doesn't really tell me how easy or hard. I'm probably going to guess that scary is probably easier than nightmare, so let's do scary. Music obviously on. That makes sense. Sound effects on. So you can scare, jump, trio, and throw. Sounds good. Let's play. Aaahh, Real Monsters. Oh no, I'm late for school. I'm almost there. Oh, midterms today. Oh, you know, that's gonna be bad, pretty bad. I guess I gotta find a shoe. Well, that makes sense. I mean, what monster is without a shoe, you know? And actually, he's wearing high heels, so you get the idea. Okay. So maybe this is a game that's based off of finding items. Oh! That's how I scare. And then I could chuck eggs or banana peels and stuff. Okay. Oh! Alright, well, let's look for a shoe. Oh, there's a book. And a smashy thing. And a monkey. Ow! Spiky. Ow. Can I eat some of this stuff, or what? Oh, I guess so. Oh, no, I only have four more fish hooky thingies. Okay, no, I guess I still have unlimited ammo, just not fishes. Okay. So one up. How do I get that? Alright, well, that ain't gonna happen. Okay, well, let's go this way. Ow! There's an umbrella. How do you... Okay, there's gonna be a way... isn't there a way to climb? I thought... Oh, no, that's that. How do you switch... Oh, there you go. Hello guys. Oh, there you go. Oh, alright. My god, come on! Alright, I don't know what that does. Let's go to, alright. Okay, she seems to be the most useful character since she's the one that can make things I can climb. There it goes. Oh, I guess not. Oh, really? Well. Follow the arrow. Now see, this is a prime example of why you do not base a video game off of a television show. Because I'm still trying to figure out what I'm doing. I think I'm just trying to find a shoe. There's an apple. Ow. Have you switch? They still have the same hits, so you can't have separate hits. I guess we're gonna go this way. Alright, what does it do when I do him? Hey, what's your axe ability? Oh. Okay, so let's see what's going on. There you go. God, does not want me to do that. Alright, there you go. How do you scare? I thought... Oh. Okay, scares are limited, apparently. There you go. Scares, I guess, are those little M things up there on the top of the screen. I guess I'm stuck. Hey! Uh-oh, I guess we're gonna go this way. Ow! Oh, I guess that would have been the ideal thing to do. Where am I going? I guess it's path this way. This definitely teaches you how to be a monster. I mean, this is Scare Tactics 101, apparently. Ow. Dude, I'm dying here. Come on. Like, I don't even know if there's a save point at all or anything. Okay, there's no double jump. Oh, okay, he jumps higher. Okay, this is kind of like a mix between an action platformer and the Lost Vikings. Because they all have their own special, unique abilities. Although, oh, is this boss? I think that would be a yes. Okay, good. Sorry for asking to say. So those arrows look like they're continuation points. That's good to know. Okay, so there's a boss here. Like, I don't really remember the show that well, so does anyone even remember what this dog's all about? Was he in the show, or is he just a junkyard dog who gets to getting tired? I just threw my shoe teacher's shoe. I'm sorry, doggy. Oh, there's the shoe. Alright, level one down. Boom!
Ready?
As ready as I'll ever be, yes. Alright, so. Oh, it sounded like points were accumulating, but that's actually the projection screen. Wait, did I gotta find the shoe again? I thought I did that. Or is that. Hey, I mean, what monster would be without a secondary shoe, you know? Yes, most people have two shoes. What is this at? What is it? A duck? Ow! Okay, this dyke is killing me. Grant, stop trying to kill me. Grant? Okay, that's how you eat. I need to push down. There's a spring thingy. Oh, come on! I'm sorry, guys. I think you're gonna be hearing lots of that little sound because it seems to be his favorite sound effect of this game. Oh, come on! No! Hi, Grant. Hi, bird. Okay, no. No, stop bouncing. Whatever. No! Ah! It's gonna be a long game. No! Oh, come on! Alright, Lars. Let's go up here. Is there something I missed? Oh, there's a bag of fish tails. I wanna see if I can kill this duck. Okay, Grant is invincible. Note to self. Does the bug heal me? Let me see. Yeah. There we go. You know what's interesting is this music slightly sounds like Banjo-Kazooie in a way. Just with the trumpets and the synthetics and whatnot. Is it just me? Maybe it's just me. Alright, I see her. Dum-dum-dum. Okay, we're gonna go like this. Now, the real question is, what exactly is this chick? I watched a show back in the day. Is she kind of like... Is she an umbrella? Is she like a stick monster? What's your dealio? What's her motivation, you know? What? Alright. Alright, well, can't go there. Oh, wait, no, I see, I want up. No, one up. No. Alright, well, I guess when you go down these, you don't really have much of a choice to do anything else. Bye, guys. You know. Well, as fun as this is. Ow. Oh, okay, wait. I see you. Go. Shoot. Oh, okay. Oh, no! No! Get back here! Good boys. Okay, so... So again, whoever voted for this game, why? Like I said, I will play any game you guys ask me to play, but so far the games that are being chosen seem to be pretty, oh, I got underwear, I guess that makes me invincible or something. Are almost unplayable. Dun, dun, dun. Oh, rat. Oh, no! Alright, you guys. I just found a new non-favorite level. Anyone else checking out those wheels in the background and the cars in the dump? Now, I was actually looking at the credits for Hour of Monsters Online on IMDb, and I actually did not realize that Classy Shukubo, or whatever you pronounce it, the people who did the Rugrats, actually created this series. Which makes sense, because if you actually look at the humans in this series of the actual cartoon show, it is actually almost looks very much like Rugrat characters, so that's kind of cool. Just a little bit of tidbit knowledge. There we go. Wait, touching that. Wait a minute. That wasn't. Was not here? Oh my effing gosh, dude. There's gotta be a way to. No. Stop rolling, poly only. There you go. Okay, really, guys. Am I missing some? No. There we go. Okay, if you jump at the very end of these little things, you do a little long hop. No, wait. We did this. We know where that goes. Let's go back down here. Oh. Ah! There's a monster book. Rawr! Okay, Grant does not die by scares, apparently. Oh, come on! Alright. This is gonna pull three ninjas on me, where you just have to watch everywhere you're jumping. What's this? Alright. Apple core, umbrella thing. Ow. Those actually are a jar of toenails, for those who never watched the show. And that apparently heals me all the way, which is good. Hey, rat. Ratata! Ratata! Oh, two ratatas. I'm assuming they can probably hurt me. Yep, that's a... Yep. Oh, yes, save. Boom. Time out. The chick was always known to be like an umbrella. Does she have like any kind of... Not to scare. You think that she would just automatically turn into like an umbrella or something? To float down? What's start do? Start pauses it. Slack does other. Alright. So again, any video game based off of a TV show, this is more or less the result you're gonna get. Oh, come on! Maybe one of these other guys are lighter. Well, let's try you. Alright, there's a technique, you gotta fall kind of on it sideways, and you go, hoo-ah! There you go. Oh, there we go. Oh, yay. Hop. Actually, now that I think about it, I recall maybe playing this game when I was living with my mom over in her India house a long time ago. Because back in the day, me and Kyle used to try and play... We had downloaded like the first SNES game titles or whatever, and I think we had attempted to try playing some of them. And we never played Three Ninjas, and we never played some of the other ones, but this one, I think we tried for like 5 minutes, and then I stopped because I thought how it was a really terrible game. And, now I have to play it. So, isn't that weird how karma bites you back in the butt? Oh, shoe. Wait, I found the shoe! Should be the end of the level, right? What the heck? Maybe it wasn't the shoe. Maybe it is a shoe. Plenty of shoes. Yow. Oh, the other night we gave our cats a bath here, like with actual water. And one of our cats, Kiko, was yelling so bad she did not like getting the bath. But Kiba was pretty cool about it. I know it's kind of random, but the reason why we're talking about that is because he sounds like... Ow! Alright, so I think we're all good. We found two shoes. I think our feet are covered. I think we're all good. Unless we gotta look for socks now. Oh, we're in the gymnasium now. We're still looking for the shoe. There's a rollerblade. Does that count? Okay, is there some button technique I'm missing? Because it seems like some of these items I should be able to use. Like, rollerblades I should be able to, like, wear. Let me see here. I mean, it's not just me, right? It feels like it makes sense that we should be able to wear those, right? See, why are they giving us all those rollerblades? It doesn't heal me, does it? Probably if I actually grabbed it. Doesn't heal me, so what? Alright, well, I'm just gonna, for now, assume that you can't use those. Oh, alright, well, climbing on the ceiling, rock 'em! Alright. Vote Kevin for school council. I'd actually vote for Bunch, because he has a funny name. Maybe Higa. I might vote for Higa. Alright, now we're going to the boys' locker. Ah! Should be humans. In the boys' locker room. Checking out some guys naked. Yeah. That's what we monsters do. Now you see, if you were a kid, wouldn't you be a little bit more or less scared by the fact that these monsters are just kind of roaming around your school, shooting shoes and clocks and fish head things at you? More or less, why are these balls... Oh, is it you? Yeah, what paper airplanes do you in school? Nothing. Get out of here. Hey, Cook. Oh, his song is in this. Oh, more gay showers. You ever like a junior high? I actually never even took a shower in junior high. Yet here there seem to be showers just all over the place. Am I missing something? Oh, I see. I think. What's this about? You think you'd be able to climb up these poles? Alright, well, I can't go that way apparently. Wait. Basketball! Yeah. Hey, water balloon chick. Oh, spit water. Spit water your mom last night. Sorry, I really don't have any interest in this. I'm sorry. Although, I would like to point out, though, if I may, look at this guy's butt when he goes up and down. Look at the guy in the pink I'm kind of going over right now. I forget his name. He's the guy with the eyeballs. He's got a booty thing going on. See if I can change him. I can't. Not on the ladder. It won't let me change him. Darn it. Just check out his butt, though. Sounds really gay, but just check it out. Here. Watch. Oh, yeah. Alright, underwear. It's invincibility. Dude, they're relentless at this school, man. There's b-balls falling over the place, roller skates hanging off on top of ladders, people shooting at you, there's bombs that explode, I guess, balls. Dude, they do not give you enough healing in this game, though. Kia! Oh, come on! Where am I at? I'm all the way back here. Fantastic. So not to be in the slightest bit racist, but I'm pretty sure those Asian kids are the ones that are firing the tennis ball machines. And not saying that Asians have to play tennis, but apparently according to this they do. Alright, let me try this again. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I don't gotta go to the left, so we'll go this way. Oh, there's a shoe! I found the shoe! No! No! Oh my god. It's gonna be one of those days. Rock 'em! Go Tigers! What? Is there a ball that just fell down right there? Oh, come on! Hey, games like this where they just have random items just falling down for no reason, like basketballs, for example, in the middle of a big, huge gym that's like 5 stories high. Oh, you know what, seriously? Oh, come on. You know there's a problem that, really? Good. Biatch. Healing. Yeah, that's right. Eat my junk. Yes! Boom shakalaka! Okay, he always seems to cut his talk short. He goes, bleh! Am I still looking for a shoe? That's 3 shoes I've already found. They really are just in love with shoes in this game. Apparently it's like the ultimate item that a human wears. Dude, really? Alright, and chick, really? Alright, well, there's just no killing you. Doo doo doo. Uh-oh. One continue. That's not good. This game isn't too long. Not this time, chick. And actually, there needs to be a pretty good plethora of lives, though. I mean, I have, what, six lives? That was pretty good. It's just, I seem to be losing them faster than I'm gaining them. That's right, punk. This is my school. Well, actually, it's not my school. Not yet. Oh, get it? I get it. Oh, wait, what? Uh-oh. Aha. What if I go on this one? Oh, yeah, I forgot. And so in the show, and now we're monsters, and they always seem to like going through the through the toilets to teleport. I guess they can go through any sewer system. See, they don't teach you that in Scare 101, though. They teach you that in Scare 201. It's a more advanced class than finding shoes the whole game. All right. Oh, wait, there you go. I guess they have a switch in the school that when a toilet explodes, it makes it go more. That makes sense. Yeah, whatever. Oh, one up, I see you. How do I get to you? This music sounds oddly very much like Krusty Super Funhouse in some points. No. There you go. Uh-oh, I see you. Was that a bathroom on the second story I had seen? One second. It's gotta be one of those three. It's probably gonna be the last one, knowing this game. Done. Probably gonna be this one. Oh, there you go. Oh, wait! I found the shoe. Oh, wait. I also only have one hit left. Ah, stupid tennis ball kid! Okay, maybe the rollerblades just increase my average speed? Ah, I just need to move a little bit faster. Maybe the umbrella makes it so I fall slower? See, I tell myself this, it makes me feel better. That's fine. We gotta do this now. There's no real technique to go through this other than just kinda walk. Then you got tennis ball kid. We're close, guys. Oh no, nope. Yeah, I countered your airplane with my aerosol can skills. Okay, so last one. Tennis ball kid. Bye, tennis ball kid. That's right. It's my gym.
Ready?
All right. Oh, now we're getting a little more advanced. Now we have to find the shoe for some odd reason and scare a human. Again, it's not points accumulating, which I keep waiting for. It's not. It's just a screen. All right. Ah, let's see here. Oh, I see what I probably could have done there. I kind of like punched the box onto that switch and not even ignore the girl. Yeah. Oh well. You know what game was a really good TV show? Video game? Animaniacs. I like Animaniacs. I thought it was a really good game. They did a good job. Why Klosky shoot Bo Cat? I have no idea. Oh, come on! Okay, wait, I got this time. Wait, timing's off, time's up. I count a squirt. Now, how do I... Oh. Well, I guess... Alright, I guess the point of the box is not to push the button, I guess it's to squish the little girl below. So apparently these monsters are really ruthless, they do not like children whatsoever. Oh. I was just seeing if I could bypass this top part with H2O and potato. See, these kids that go to school, they're very fancy, they have to learn about the higher level stuff like water and potatoes. Fun drive. Ah, 20 hours. Dave Warhol for president. Wasn't Dave Warhol one of the executive producers producers that made this show? Ah, that's some hidden trivia right there. Ah. Let's go in this toilet. Nope. Well, at least the creatures do not respond, though. That's kind of nice. Boom. And then this music almost sounds like a mixture of a Goofy movie. Hang top, Gilligan. Ah! Ha 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 ha. Ah. That was a Goofy movie reference, by the way, everyone. Guess we're done with toilets. Oh, wait. Where there's a rat, there's a way. Parent meeting in the gym today. Oh, maybe I'll see them. Hi. I'm gonna leave my scare. I'm not using them because I'm gonna scare Mr. Nerdy McGee, wherever he's at. Ow. I guess it's running late, so she's freaking out. Oh, there's undies. Aw, oh, come on. Oh well. Dude, these chicks are freaking out. Oh my, come on! Oh, toenails. Yes. I guess you're so late to school, they don't even, or to class, that they don't even realize that there's monsters walking around their school. Oh, wait. Wait, I know how to get that. There's, not yours. Yours. There you go. I saw that. No! Toenails! Alright, scare. I need that anyways. Uh-oh. Dude, these kids are late for school. They freaking get crazy. Forward's XC was 59, X is 55, you're right. Wait, was that the guy I had to scare? Oh, no. Nerds apparently don't fight back. is also good to know. It's a real life lesson right there. As she was going to the restroom, I interrupted her, sorry. Dude, these kids just... You see, this is a true statement about kids that go to school. They just have no regard, no respect for anything, you know? Even little walking umbrellas, you'd think they would have some respect for. Wait, we're not playing this game again. Although doing the moonwalk is fun, that's not what I'm trying to do. There we go. There we go. So lots of monster scare books. So either this guy's a boss, or he's just... They want to make sure I have enough scares. Oh, there's a shoe. I saw that. There you go. Is that... Oh, come on! I'm this far back, really? So, I played all the Mega Man games, the original ones for the Nintendo, and I thought back then they hated kids. They really hated kids, even with the Super Nintendo. Well, actually, it's either that or okay. I usually play RPGs, right? So, it's also a possibility that they challenged kids more back in the day and that they're making games too easy now. That's also another possibility, too, because I have to admit, for just basic platforming, this isn't as easy as the old, you know, Sonic the Hedgehog and stuff that I'm used to playing when I was a kid. Really? Am I supposed to be climbing this? No? Oh. Oh, I guess he's a boss. Really? Wait, did I win? That was it? Oh, I remember that little bee thing looking thing. Avoid jump into five baskets. Wait, what?
Ready?
Poltergeist for profit. I need to find a coffee cup. Of course. Because our monsters are working overtime and they need their coffee. Oh, I'm back in the dump again. This game's getting really original. Do 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 do. There we go. Okay, those are sluice gates. They probably open up with a combination of these switches. Yep. And my guess is one of these will have the coffee cup, and then the ending will be in a different one, probably. Okay. What? No. Alright, so let's not go that way. That seems to be like an instant death area. There's no boat rig. There you go. Darn rats. When they mean platform adventure, they mean platform adventure. Get it? Cause I'm riding on platforms. I crack myself up sometimes. All right. Ow. Some Sonic the Hedgehog 2 skills. Alright, the question is what I do now. What? Okay, the only thing I can think of... Oh! Aha! Trixie McGee! Wait, where'd the water go? Grant. Oh, you again, huh? Yeah, I know how to take care of you. Mid-boss. Oh, sorry. Wait, what? Am I supposed to fight you? Why am I fighting this guy? I thought he was a good guy. Well, actually, I haven't watched this show in a long time, so I could be wrong. But so far, Mr. Fang here. Actually, they make some of the levels more difficult than they do the bosses. Cause... Oh, yeah, okay. Hi. Bye. Yeah, really? Alright, well.
Ready?
Uh-oh. This is where Claire's dad from Heroes works. The paper factory. Bennett, where are you? Ow! Did you spill coffee on me? Do-na-do-na-do-na. See, my goal is with this game to actually try not to complain as much. I'm just trying to deal with it one level at a time. Because it should be enjoyable for you to watch as well. Although some people actually enjoy when I complain when I play video games, so I'll give you a mix. Hey. Hey, y'all. Okay, now we're doing some Mega Man 2 ice levels. Yeah, unfortunately for you, I know how to do you levels. Oh, ah! Well, this is one of the only platforms I've seen that actually, in the early days, if you fell from a gigantic height, it actually hurt you. Most of the other ones, like Sonic and Mario, you can fall from pretty much any height and not get hurt. So that's actually one cool thing about this, is they actually make it a little bit more difficult prefer when you do these impossible jumps. One second, let's change to you. You seem to have also have greater speed. Does anyone hear that? Oh, it's you. I don't want to go too high. But yeah, I want to get over there. That seems to be the ideal place, because that's a trap. There we go. No! Folks, at the rate this is going, there may not be a completion on this game. It might just be a playthrough of me trying to attempt to play it, but there are just some games that are that bad. This is a prime example of one of them. So we're going to give this continue a last go, see if I can attempt to finish it on this last go. If not, on to the next, I say, because some games are just not worth it, and this is one of those examples. Alright, well, I'm gonna try it though. But this may not be as long as my other video, because the other one I actually beat for 3 ninjas, so this might only be like an hour and 20, maybe. Ah, no! And boom. Class C Supo. Let me try here. There we go. There we go. Come on. Well, I'm actually not in the box factory. I think I'm actually in a mail room, actually. I think. Totally not where I thought I was. That's fine, though. Either way, I'm trying to scare my way to a cup of joe. Okay. Is that a boss? Wait. Oh, good. I thought that this was a trap all the way down to where I was. Good. There we go. Finally, we needed one of those a long time ago. Hi, Mr. Mailman. McGee. Uh-oh. Those are heavy packages. Is that how they actually treat your packages in the mail? Wow, and if you ever go to the mail room, by the way, they're swinging bags of mail. And people wonder why sometimes our mail system is really slow. Well, this is a behind-the-scenes look at how it actually goes down. Yeah, I never played as Fatty Miggy over there. Let me see here. No. Alright, that's exciting. Wait, now what? Oh, okay. Oh, more swinging the mailbags? That makes sense. Hi. Yeah, I keep forgetting that I can actually scare too if I really needed to. Not that I really need to, but if there is a guy that's being annoying, like all across the screen, I can be like, rawr, and kill him. Forgetting, because these ones I don't actually have to scare anyone. I just gotta find my cup of Joe so I can make it through the day. Dun, dun, dun. Hey, here's a question for anyone that has actually watched the Ariel Monster show. The guy with the four legs with the high heels, was he, was he, I mean, not that it makes a difference, he is, you know, it's not gonna make me look at him any differently, but at the same time, you know, he wore four high heels and he talked with a British accent. Not saying all British people are, like, gay or anything, but at the same time, I think he especially was. Oh, wait, alright. Save spot, any point would be great. Or end of level. What is... Oh. Cup of Joe. Hi.
Ready?
I mean, I guess it's probably 8 levels, so that was level 7. So, this would be level number 8 now. Or 7. Arm. This basket's red. All right. There we go. Down. The only thing I really dislike about this game, I mean, I'm the story's like whatever, it's not really a story, I understand. Thank you, Breakable Fours. Is that the music, there's like 3 songs that alternate. This is, I think, the song for the first, like, 3 levels. And they're already using it again. So, I'm not sure if, the guy from Devo, whatever his name is, Mark Mothersbaugh, I'm not sure if he did the... Really? I'm not sure if he did the music for this game, but if he did, you know, he has more musical talent than to make 3 songs, you know? Of course I would do that. Oh, wow. Where am I? Oh, I'm not that far away since I barely started the level. The goal would be to not drop in there. And there are breakable floors. There we go. And of course I would. Oh wait. Hum. There we go. I don't know what that does, but... Oh, it does that. Is he hitting me with a clipboard? Is that what that is? It's like a clipboard with a string. He's using it kind of like a whip of sorts. Wait. There we go. Yeah, you just got head right there. Oh no! I'm pretty sure I need that. Pretty sure, because if it's pushable. Ah! That was worth the push. I don't think I need any more. Nah, I'm good. Oh, sorry for grinding so much, guys. I woke up really early this morning to go to an event over in the Esmeralda to find out that I was not supposed to go to that event in Esmeralda. So I've stayed awake ever since. I don't go back to work till like 4:30 today or 4, something like that. So bear with me if I yawn a bit because I should really be taking a nap. Okay. But instead I'm playing this game for your amusement. And today is Sunday, by the way. I was going to play this earlier, but honestly I just haven't had time this week. I've had it's been an interesting week because Black Friday's coming up, so you know how we gotta prepare over at the Best Buy. So yeah. Okay, she's almost too tall to do this. We gotta switch to that. Is his name Ick? Ick or Icarus or something like that? Or Eek? Because, man, I haven't watched these shows since I was a kid. Like, honestly, Abigail Monster is probably my least watched show out of all the major Nicktoons. So I don't remember exactly what his name was. Yeah, you want me to go down, but I probably gotta hit a switch up here. Or not. Wait, then where... Oh. You see how this game rolls? It's like a roly-poly. Nah, the other one will probably be open. No? Aha! Oh, no, no. I'll go over here if I will. Wait, I think I just missed a life. My question is it worth risking my last hits for? In this game, yes. Yes, it is. Yeah, I see you. Wait, how did I get you? Oh, well. Okay, apparently machinery is not scared of monsters. That is good to know. And that guy sounds like a chicken. I'm pretty sure it's a guy. Ow. It's a guy. That sounds like a chick. Wow. Do do. Wait. Do I have to get the cup of Joe? Yeah, because the X is not going bang, bang, bang. Yeah, see? There you go.
Ready?
Poltergeisting for profit. Scare lunch lady. Wherever she is. Is she a boss? I think she's a boss. I think I had to hear boxes. That's for the top one. Then I gotta switch this one. Yep. Oh, wait, no. No, no. Okay, I see. It's a tricky boss. No, wait, you were the right way. Ooh. No, almost got you, almost got you. Bye. Dunzo! Okay, if I had to guess, I would say it's probably only one more set of levels, but knowing this game, it's probably only halfway through, so it's probably another whole set of levels. Oh, okay. You like my bonus game skills? Nightmares 113B.
Ready?
Wait. Does that mean if I would have started off at nightmare level, I would have started off here? Or is that just saying that this is the class, like, it's not 110A or whatever, 101A? What the f- Really? This might be the same game over again, but with harder difficulty. Well, that looks a bit different, I think. I think. Yeah, that wasn't the case in the last one. Wow, they're just not messing around anymore, are they? This game's not for child's play. Just trying to figure out how that's supposed to happen. Oh, gotcha. Toenails, thank you. Boom. Oh, by the way, I just realized. So I'm back in the dump again. Seems to be where all stuff magically starts off and where all things end. The way this game seems to be working, so basically I start off in a dump and then I go to an outside human area, so that this is teaching me what I probably need to look for. Like, I need to look for shoes or a cup of joe. And then when you're in the real world, that's what you need to look for in real life, when you're out in the actual scare hunt. Alright, so the story makes a bit more sense now. Now, normally I would scour the whole level for the item, but so far it seems like that... Get off of me. So far, it seems like it's at the end of every level. Really? Oh, there it is, the switch. I saw it. Can I kill you?
Hehe. I talk like this in the show. Hehe. I'm a bee. Haha. I'm a bee with a leg. I'm the scariest creature there ever was. It's like I'm part human, part bee, part mosquito. And I like to grab you over and over again, not hurt you, just to make it that much more annoying. There you go.
Well, that's what he sounded like in the show, I think. If I recall. There you go. Oh, see? See, it's always right there by the exit. Then there's one more training episode. See? Where you gotta... Or one more training episode, one more training level where you gotta figure out where exactly you're trying to go. Oh, no, no, I guess not. Guess I'm actually in the museum now and I'm looking for that skull. But it's gotta be that skull. Why? Don't ask. But it is gotta be that. What the? I guess this is like Night at the Museum. Monsters come alive at night. They must have the tablet of Muhammad Ali or whatever it is. Hi. Now I feel like I'm playing Jurassic Park on Sega Genesis, where I'm fighting the Velociraptors, the Lost Area. Yeah. Or the T-Rex. Oh, no, I'm sorry, no, it's Velociraptors or Dr. Grant. Which, actually, I'm trying to remember which one was harder, I think. The Velociraptors, I think, had it harder. Because Dr. Grant had to shoot the pillars. That was a lot more difficult, actually, now I think about it. Alright, I'm going up. Put some hidden there. Okay, the real question is, how do I get up? These don't bounce you, do you? No, it's spike you. I would like to go up, if you could tell me how. Can I climb onto you? No. Alright. Oh, wait. There you go. Stay away, stay away. Climbing on the neck of this dude and that dude. Hi. Hi. And don't even bother asking me why there's bones sticking out of the walls here. They need to talk to their janitor and see what's going on. At night in the museum. Actually, a better question would be, instead of wondering why there's bones sticking on the walls, why are there little heads that are swinging off of chains? That would probably be a better question to ask as far as what's going on in this museum. Now, can I just grab, like, any skull? Does it have to be their official skull? And why was that skull in the dump in the first place anyways? Did someone rob a museum and dump it there? They don't want to leave the hard evidence in the dump. Hi. Dog bones. Spinny dog bones. Okay, last one stays for twice as long. It's good to know. Oh, this is gonna be the death of me. Boing. Ooh, barely. Oh, no, I wasn't barely. I hit. Oh. Arr. Wait, how far back am I? I'm all the way back here. Really? Really, guys? Alright, well, I'm officially starting to slowly hate this game. It's a little bit on the repetitive side. Save spots are pretty far apart and almost non-existent. Storyline is not really there, other than try to find some item in human habitats. Oh, two more lives, and I think we're done with this game. So the ninjas, I died early on, I did easy, because it was doable. It's probably as doable if I really, really dedicate my time to learning where everything's at and everything. But honestly, it just really isn't worth my time. There we go. Animation point, a little crawly, creepy crawler. Hi. Wait. Yeah. Can you scare when you're on here? No. Wait, what? Really? Really, guys? Oh my god! Yeah.